Okay, hello dear friends. Here I am at Stanford University Cantor Museum. And here is an exhibition. It's been here almost 1 year or something. It's Nick Cave's art pieces. It's called Sound Suit. So it's quite an interesting piece. And yesterday I came here and there was one curator and she did such a wonderful job in explaining it. So I got to understand a little bit. Nick Cave, he was not a singer, Nick Cave. Although I have seen Nick Cave in San Francisco for his exhibition, for his concert, but this Nick Cave is a black American, an artist, and this name is Nick Cave. So he started from finding a lot of little twigs, little tree branches. And he found those branches. What did he do with it? Oh, this is Nick Cave. This is him. So, the very first original in place piece was that he found some twigs and then he started to think about an idea to put them one by one and made into a costume. And when he made this costume, he something like this shape, a straight shape, is relatively easy for him to get in. And then he wore it, and then he suddenly found it was so liberating that he found himself a total new, different person. Sometimes it's like when we do costume party or we dress up cosplay, we dress up in another dress, and in another costume, then we change our personality, our way of behave. But what he found is this total freedom into this kind of clothing. So he started from that idea. He started to dance. And when he danced, he moved around and danced and found the liberating spirit. And there was sound from this costume. So he decided to call this costume Sound Suit. So there are more of these sound suits, and there is a movie about this sound suit. Here is one wonderful piece. And people doing the performing. And with this arquebus, it makes the sound. So after he made his very first piece, he started to develop into a trash to treasure project. It becomes a community art project. So there are thousands of people working with him and they look for materials from a recycle place or from Salvation Army in Goodwill. They got all the material and then they resorted. And all the socks were knitted and custom designed and made particularly for this particular suit everything is arranged. So thousands of people walking with him. And it becomes a community build up and recreation. It's quite interesting that that people can think of this totally different idea. And now it becomes from his original idea, now it becomes kind of a fashion, fashion business or industry. And a lot of people working with him together. And I'm sure they are developing into different style and tells different stories, which is already away from the original twigs and recycle. It become a unique art form of its own. And another thing is, the meticulous design. And another thing about this museum, yesterday I came here and got some information about this Anderson collection. So this museum, Anderson decided to donate, but not donate to Stanford Museum, the Cantor Museum. They make it their own individual place. So Stanford fundraised and built the facility of this museum. And the architect was the same architect who designed the Bean Concert Hall. The other day we went to see a concert hall, maybe when I finish this museum, we will go to take a look of that concert hall. So the architect, before making this design, he visited Anderson's house and looked around how he kept his collections, the way his the art piece was arranged, and the way the house is built. And Anderson's house was kind of a ranch style house, so with a long corridor and side little rooms. So you can see it's a long hall or corridor and little rooms on the side. You can go in and visit. The idea and the inspiration was got from the Anderson house. If I did not know it, I could not understand the architect of this. And just feel quite interesting to know something, the history of it. And the architect designed these stairs, kind of a trompe-l'oeil, kind of intentionally making the beginning wider and going up narrower. So this way it looks as if use the perspective feeling makes the beauty, the museum looks much larger, longer, as if you are seeing the perspective. Let's go up. So the stairs from wider to become narrower. And if you walk in it, you actually cannot see that it is not parallel to the wall. It seems is parallel to the bordering wall. So you can go to go to different exhibition chamber, and that red chair is a study room, and there was always a movie repeating about the family donation, and there are books and coloring page. I often come here to look at the coloring page and look at the books. Not much coloring page, but mostly the books. This is a new piece. I haven't seen it before. There are some new pieces coming in. And Stanford's museum, they have a special day. Every second Sunday is a kind of open house. They have a lot of activities, kids' thumb printing and Facebook analog studio came here to do some printing workshop, photoing workshop. It's quite interesting. I came here yesterday. So this is another piece of Nick Cave's work. Okay, so remember this piece of artwork. I have done this last time or a few times ago, a few months or years ago, about this piece of painting. And the artist is Mark. Let me see. His name is Mark Tenzi, Mark Tenzi. And as the curator making the explanation, there was one lady on the side, on my side, and she said she used to be a classmate of Mark Tenzi, this artist. And they are having 50 years school anniversary, 50 years back to school after graduation. So she is going back, because he, Mark Tenzi, is going back to the school. So he wanted to see him. He remember when they were in high school or middle school. When they were in high school, Mark Tenzi was always drawing. Whenever she looked back, she saw him doing the drawing. And Mark Tenzi was famous for his accuracy and art skill in vividly reproduce the image of the original painting. It was a San Jose artist. We have already seen this picture. This picture was by the origin of this picture was one photographer's work, and this photographer at the beginning of the century or at last century, end of last century, he used a mule, he used the very basic transportation without car, went to Yosemite and took a lot of pictures, and he gave this picture to the president at that time, and the president saw the picture and decided to make the Yosemite into national park. Of course, it could not be this simple, but definitely the photography of the artist had made a big influence. So Mark Tenzi copied that painting, not really copied, he was inspired by that particular painter, a particular picture. So we need to appreciate nature with our own eyes and get rid of the cameras. Get rid of the cameras. Look at nature. Look at the real world. And he used tissue paper and used sponge, Q-tip to execute those little details. I think it's a good place to stop. Here is another piece of art, and let me see who made it. The artist is glass cube Larry Ball. Larry Ball. So when you see this piece of art, what do you think? What do you see? Yesterday, when the curator asked me this question, I said, I see perfection. Immediately, I see perfection. This reminds me of the coffee cube and the beautiful little containers. It's just so perfect. The original intention of the artist is that you can see through this piece of artwork, but at the same time, the artist is inviting you to be part of the art. You are not only seeing the art, you are not only seeing the world behind this piece of art, you are also seeing yourself reflected in this art piece. It was a movement at that time, 60s, 70s, that making art and also making architects, while blending it into the surrounding environment. So inviting the viewer to be part of the art. And each art could be and should be explained or experienced and observed by the viewer differently. What I see is my leg. What I see is what reflecting me, and what you see is what reflecting you by you. Isn't it interesting? More than that is interesting. sometimes, if you force yourself to understand it, to try to understand, you will be very much at loss because you cannot understand. And sometimes you loosen up yourself and be part of it and enjoy it. Be part of it, or ignore it, or just let it take its life of its own, and you live your life of your own. It makes the museum experience a bit more enjoyable. And this shade is computer designed, I heard. So it has different, according to the sun, it has different darkness.